Welcome back everyone, my name is Abdullah Ghori from Alpha Technology, and in this video we will talk about pass by value and pass by reference, and we will see that how pass by value works and how pass by reference works in C++ programming. So in C++ we create some user defined function that we have learned in some of previous videos, but in this video we will discuss that how we can pass some values to the functions, and how we can pass the reference to the function, and what is different between pass by value and pass by reference. We will see that in this video. Let's talk about first pass by value. So normally we create some functions, like we have a function called void change. So this is just an example of pass by value. So here we will accept a number called num. So I have declared the function, and now I will go down and implement this function. So I will say void, and here I will name this function change, and I will accept num here. So this num, basically this thing is known as setting the parameters. So whenever we pass anything, it will known as argument. So this thing is known as parameters. So here what I will do, I will say that num is equal to 85. So let's say we are saying just that. And here we will go here and we will create a int num which is equal to 8. So here let me first print the value of num. So I will print num is equal to, and here I will print the value of num. And after that I will call our change method, and I will pass num into that method. So this thing known as argument. So we are passing the argument. So here we will again print the value of num, and if we run this program, so let me build and run this program, and you can see that the value of num, when we just assign 8 to the num, it is equal to num. So it's good. But when we pass this num in our change variable, it doesn't change the actual value, because if it's changed, it should be 85, but it's 8 as it is. So this thing is known as pass by value. The point to be noted is that in pass by value, the actual value of the variables will not be changed. Like here num is equal to 8. So whenever we pass num here, actually we are passing num here, so it does not change the actual value of num. So we are just passing the value of num. Okay, so let's see another example for the pass by reference. So let me delete this thing, and for the pass by reference we need to declare the method something like that. So we will say change, and here we will say that int address of num. So here we are accepting not a value, we are accepting a reference. So we will go down and we will implement our method. We will say change, and we'll say int address of num. At the definition of function, we will say that our num is equal to 85. So now if we run this program, what it will do, it will print first 8 and then 85. Why it is? Because here the value of num is 8, so it's printing num equal to 8. But at down we are saying that change, and we are passing the reference of num variable. Whenever we pass the reference, it will change the actual value of the variable. So here we are passing num. So because it is accepting a reference of a variable, so we are not passing the actual value, we are passing the reference of the num variable. So it will change the actual value of num variable, because reference is just like the address of the variable where the data is stored in the memory. So it is changing that memory address, so it is changing the value of that memory address. So this thing known as pass by reference. So that's how pass by reference and pass by value works in C++. So point to be noted is that whenever we declare methods and we didn't have this address sign, that means this method or function will accept a value. So this thing is known as pass by value. And whenever we declare a method along with and we declare the variable, are we accepting the argument along with the address sign? It means we are not accepting the actual value, we are accepting the actual reference of the variable. So in the pass by value, the value of the variable will not be changed. In pass by reference, the actual value of the variable will be changed. Another thing is that when we are passing something, this thing is known as argument, and when we implement or declare the function and we set any variable, it is known as setting the parameters. So it's known as parameter, and we pass something, it's known as argument. So hope you enjoy this video. If you enjoy this video, hit the like button, and if you have any question, you can comment down below. I will answer your all the question. Do subscribe our channel for more videos on C++ programming.